Reading with Val.
Hi guys, my name is Valerie. Are you looking for a perfect read? A read that will keep you on the edge of your seat every single moment of the book? Well, today I am going to be reviewing a book that definitely has all those opponents. It is called A Pinch of Magic. And it is by Michelle Harrison. And it is a fantasy book. And I would rate this book a 10 out of 10. I got this book from Owl Crate Jr. And I did the unboxing right somewhere here. And go check it out. It was really cool. And I actually did it blindfolded. But basically, I got this book inside the box and so surprised to see that. Like, the cover is so magical. You can see there are three girls and they all have glowing objects. And the cover basically heads in the direction of fantasy and kind of really, really magical stuff. And so it did head to that place. And there's so many secrets in this book. Like, I was gasping, like, why did he do that or whatever? But, like, it was so amazing that I couldn't stop reading it. Like, don't tell my parents, but I was reading it when they thought I was sleeping. Yep. It was super amazing. I just couldn't keep my eyes off the book, and I did everything I could to read it. Inside the Owl Crate box, Michelle Harrison wrote me a letter. Well, wrote the reader a letter. Said, "Dear reader, when I was little, my two older sisters filled my head with stories of magic and adventure. I grew up longing to have an adventure of my own, and eventually discovered I could do just that by writing stories. A Pinch of Magic is about three very different sisters who each inherit a magical object. But the Wittershins, Betty, Fliss, and Charlie, are also living under a family curse that threatens their lives. In order to have a future, the girls must dig deep into the past, where they learn that sisterly love isn't always sweet. Can the Wittershins use their powers to break the curse? Or will they end up in more danger? I'll leave you to find out. Happy reading, Michelle Harrison." The bottom part of the letter kind of, it's like a summary of the book. Betty is the main character, I would say, and her two sisters are also a big component in this book. And Betty and Charlie, the two youngest ones, find out that they can inherit a magical object. And Fliss already knows, the oldest sister knows, because she already had that object for a few years already. And I'm gonna show you what the things are and what they do. So here is Charlie, and this is her bag. And what the bag can do, it can travel her to any place she wants. So it's basically like a transportation bag, and it's really cool. This is Betty, and she's holding a nesting doll. And what the nesting doll can do is it can make her invisible, which is super cool. But the people who are invisible can still be touched and heard and smelled. And then finally, here's Fliss. She's the oldest one. And she has a mirror in her hand. And that mirror, what it can do is it can talk to people all around the world. And those three objects are super important in this book too. And I'll explain what they use for it. The three girls find out that they're under a family curse. And the family curse is that they can't leave Crowstone. And Crowstone is the place that they live. And if they do leave by the next sunset or sunrise, they will die. This is the prison here. And it's a really creepy, mysterious, dark place. And it has to do a lot about the Wittershins' history. And all three sisters are determined to break the curse. But a lot of people in their family have tried. But they all can't seem to have fun, like, they all can't seem to have done it. But they are still determined. If I were them, I'd be super scared. I'd just never leave Crowstone, like, ever. Because, I mean, who knows? You could risk your life. Your life is in danger, basically. And I really just think that all three sisters are super brave, super determined to make history in their families. And I love this book because it is just an amazing book about secrets and curses and family. One thing that I can connect to the sisters in this book is that they have a lot of fights in this book, and I have a lot of fights with my sister sometimes. There were some really big secrets in this book that made it super fun to read, just because there's so many secrets that there are only so many secrets that you can unravel, and it's just the best book about magic and curses that I have ever read before, and that says a lot because I do not like fantasy. I mean, I like fantasy books. Like, I love this book, but it's not in my preferable range of read. But I do love to try some really good fantasy books, and this proved me wrong. This book proved me so wrong, and I just really want you guys to read it and spread the word. There's an amazing book called A Pinch of Magic that you have to read. I would recommend this book to kids between the ages 9 through 12. This book is seriously amazing. And thank you to Owl Crate again for bringing me this book. I really loved it. I definitely would not have picked this book on my own. So thank you guys for doing that for me. And seriously amazing, guys. And it's just, you have to read it. And I heard that there's a sequel. So I'm going to read this book after. Remember to read on, have fun, and dream big. See you guys later. Bye!